Hi, good evening everyone. The festive season is soon coming up and in the next few days we are all busy preparing for it. It's less than a week from now and I'm already getting all my Diwali decorations out from the storage. Tomorrow I have a Diwali dinner to go for, and which I'm already feeling so very festive. Now this brings us to a very important aspect of this festive season, which is eating mindfully. Now, as you all know that this season brings us so many opportunities for us to cheat, as you have loads of options to choose from, mithais to attending so many parties and having so much of festive food around you. So today we are going to talk about the festive cheat code. We will equip you to cheat mindfully this festive season. And of course, by saying this, we are not saying ideally you should cheat, but be mindful of what you're eating. So if you have to cheat, here are a few pointers which could help you to stay healthy this festive season. So here are the three mantras if you have to cheat. So first is choose wisely. Second is manage your frequency. And third is to create a balance. Now firstly is to choose wisely. If you're visiting friends and family, and if you have a choice of foods presented to you, you should pick your choices. Use this quick guide on what you can choose and what is a lesser evil. In the main course, if you have a choice between various food items, pick veggies and pick dals and pulses over the gravies, because gravies are usually fat laden. Say choose chole, pulses, dals, veggies over your, say, butter masalas or malai koftas. In snacks, choose baked snacks over fried snacks. You can choose, say, if you have nuts, you can choose the raw, unsalted and over the fried ones. You should choose like finger foods of your veggie sticks instead of chips. If you have to make a choice between mithai, choose wholesome mithais over the syrupy ones. For example, choose besan laddu or say choose sandesh over your gulab jamun, jalebis or your malpuas. Second is to manage frequency. Now while actually Diwali is only 3 to 4 days, the festive season is spread around 10 to 12 days of celebrations, your parties, gatherings and so on. So if you have multiple events or multiple opportunities back to back over a couple of days, then choose the days you will cheat and the remaining days keep it clean. If you cheat every day, means you will be piling up more of calories, which will be then difficult for you to get rid of and to recover from. The third that we are going to talk about is create a balance. Once you have decided your cheat days and you have decided what you're going to cheat, say for a dinner, a particular day, then rest of the days, balance your meals. Eat a simpler meal the rest of the day, nothing that makes you feel more bloated or more heavy. Keep yourself hydrated, a little extra than usual, because often the cheat meals tend to kind of have water retention and you will need to drink more water. Thirdly, have a fruit bowl or say a bowl of soup before the cheat meal. So you have kind of filled yourself and not starving, and thus less chances of you hogging over a cheat meal. Don't skip a meal thinking that you're going to hog in the cheat meal, because when you're hungry and you are at a peak of your hunger pangs, you will not tend to eat mindfully. So don't skip a meal. So remember these three pointers, that is choose wisely, manage your frequency and create a balance. And yes, very important is don't forget to exercise every single day, even during the festive season. It is, in fact, you should exercise a bit more to burn that extra calories. Eat a lot of fruits to hydrate and to satiate your sweet cravings. Keep your dry fruits handy, like your peaches, your plum, your dates, to satiate your sweet cravings. So if you keep these pointers in mind, you can eat mindfully and have a fantastic festive season to enjoy. So this festive season, stay healthy and choose mindfully. Thank you.